16 of 21 cassettes, The Waiting on God, Chicago, 1992, continuing the Tuesday morning session number 76, 2392.
Then his half, he gave to the mother to wrap the baby that was being born outside the home. That's one story. Praise the Lord.
She was away from the market and did not know when he died.
Yes.
So she went to market and as the way
back, she had it in the street.
Yeah.
So I rushed and first I wrapped it in my shirt and then Hilda said, well, what are you doing? I said, everything we have is supposed to be, we're supposed to have half and half because we are partners, isn't that right?
Yes.
I said, this is a warm country. I don't use cover anyway, so if you want to get hot with one half, I'm giving my half away.
And you give your half a sheet to her to wrap the baby in to take it home.
Thank you, Lord. You need to pray for Haiti a lot because things are getting to be terrible. They're sending them back to us. The other day, I went to take care of some children in a home because I also practice medicine. And of course, our people, they don't have much, but they are clean. After I finished, she said, the lady said, can I give you some water to wash your hand? I said, oh, please, because, you know, there's a lot of germs and we have to be careful. So she brought me the water and she said, I am sorry, Pastor. We don't have soap. They can't even afford it. When you can't even afford food, you can hardly afford soap, although you know you need it. So the next day, I got her big bar. I got the family a big bar of toilet soap. And 2 days again, I come back. She needed for me to wash my hand, and she said, we don't have soap. I said, now, how come it's like you're all sending that money to me and for me not to find it to get here? You say, well, how come? I said, how come you don't have any soap? I thought I got you a bar. She said, Pastor, it has become the community soap. So an average of 10 people in each house, and can you imagine about 10 of them using it to bathe, to wash their face, so I had to get some more. So I'm here to tell you the only thing that's keeping us going is because people are willing to share. And I was happy. I said, that's all right. We'll get you some more soap, and you just share it with as many people. This is why, I don't know if I'm doing the wrong thing, but I'll confess it now. Every time I wash my face with one of those soap that they have in my room, I know they're going to throw it away, so I wash once and they're in my suitcase. I'm taking them every day.
Oh, yeah.
Because instead of letting this big hotel throw soap away, I'm going to spread it out and in a day they will be finished. I'm taking those soap where they will be varnished, not taken away, I mean rubbing their face. So I am happy to be here, and thank you again, everyone who contributed and making me come here. I can see now why the devil was fighting so hard. So I'm happy, and I better sit down.
Praise
so
the Lord.
My emergency brake doesn't give out, because if the hydraulic spiritual give out and the emergency, I'll be running all over this place. So God bless you again, and thank you, my brother.
Yes, sir.
I love you, and you are a servant of God. You keep going, and you're going to bring many more souls yet to our Lord Jesus. He's a jewel, and I love you, and I love everybody. If you love him, then I love you too. So if you want me to love you, you just love this man. You see if I don't. Praise the Lord. Thank you.
Glory to all to Jesus. Bless you, Jesus. Bless you, Jesus. Bless you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
My brain shoes, and I got so excited today, I took them off here and I didn't even have time to put it. So they're still doing very good, so you don't worry about shoes either, because when the men of God give you something good, they last long, so yes. I still have them.
I bought him a pair of shoes for he and his wife and someone I've forgotten, and we had a great time on the shoe business. Praise the Lord. And those are the shoes?
Yes.
Thank you.
They're still here.
Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. The children of Israel, you know, wore the same sandals and shoes for 40 years. The same garments they went in, and that's all they had. There wasn't any clothing stores in the wilderness. So, and they never grew threadbare in 40 years.
Thank you, Jesus.
And so here's the missionary, still got the shoes. The Lord helped us through God's people helping provide for me to get him shoes. Praise the Lord. And his wife, and a pastor's wife.
Yes.
Yes, praise the Lord. All right, we'll sing that song in French. Thank you. That's the one that encouraged him, because see, it helped him. What that said to him in French gave him courage when he knew that they may take everything of their living, the beds and everything they've had, away.
This song says, "Why art thou cast down, my soul? Why do you groan within me? Hope in God, for he is my salvation."
Pourquoi t'abattu mon âme et
Hallelujah. Thank you very much. Now, the Light family, that's Daniel and John and Jeannie. I'd requested some time ago that they would get some songs, so they're going to sing, the Lord willing. It's a tremendous gift that God has given to the Helbing family. That's a great gift, what he gave to the Light family.
Thank you, Jesus.
It's really a marvel. It really is. It's a great gift. And we want to sanctify and give God all the glory for this. Because you three children, oh, how the Lord has worked through you to help us and help others. And we want to thank you for the Holy Spirit to lead. Let all things now living, if you please. I was thinking before they sing, Terry Williams, will you come up and lead us in a chorus? All stand while Terry leads us in a chorus, and the Light trio will get arranged here in a moment or two. We need to stand up a little bit. I noticed a lot of people leave. About 30, 40 minutes ago, there's so many people left, I didn't know whether they're all going to leave. It's a sight. Oh, there's just so many people leaving the auditorium, and many. If you'd sit up here, you'd say, "Oh, Jesus, help us." Oh, yeah, there's so many. Yeah, that's so. I'm so glad you stayed. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, just lead us in a chorus and a stanza.
I serve a risen Savior, he's in the world today. I know that he is living, whatever men may say. I see his hand of mercy, I hear his voice of cheer. And just the time I meet him, he's always near. He lives. Today he walks with me and talks
Amen.
With me along life's narrow way. He lives, salvation to impart. You ask me how I know he lives. He is with him.
Oh.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. You may be seated. To have Jesus live in our heart, the Holy Spirit, in peace and joy and love for everybody. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. I'm so glad to have our precious ones, the Light family.
Amen.
Oh, my. Hallelujah. Jenny and Jeannie and Daniel and John. Praise the Lord. Thank you.
Let all things now living a song of thanksgiving to God the Creator triumphantly raise, who fashioned and made us, protected and stayed us, who guided us on to the end of our days. His banners are o'er us, his light shows before us, a pillar of us shining forth in the night, till shadows have vanished and darkness is banished, as forward we travel from light into light. His longing enforces the stars in their courses, the sun in his orbit obediently shine, the hills and the mountains, the rivers and fountains, the deeps of the ocean proclaim him divine. We too should be voicing our love and rejoicing with glad adoration, a song that us praise. Till all things now living, united in thanksgiving to God in the highest. Hosanna.
On me, breath of God. That was beautiful.
Amen.
And think, they had never sung together until we called on them a few years ago. They have outstanding voices, but never had just gotten together to sing, because there's so much going on. So many different responsibilities, opportunities. And I requested that they sing as a family. And here you heard it. I never heard that song before. I've been to church 76 years, never heard this one. Praise the Lord. Beautiful.
Yes, sir.
Oh, the message in it and the melody. Thank you, Jesus. Praise the Lord.
Glory.
Until my heart is clean.
Jesus' name. this family because Jesus told me in 1969 to make a telephone call. That's why we had them. He led me to make a telephone call and gave me a revelation. And that's why we have privilege of having the lights with us. And then for that, we would have missed you.
So much through this. I believe we can get help. We've been praying for help for these souls. I believe it'll come. Oh, this is wonderful. Oh, it's holy. It's from our Father. What a gift. Oh, we're in a concert. Oh, it's like heaven. Isn't it wonderful? Oh, we praise the name of the Lord. Oh, it's great. You're going to get help. You're going to get help through these songs. Oh, it's a divine gift. Oh, it's from God above. Oh, it's just help. Oh, just keep doing it. It's helping our souls. It's bringing victory. It's bringing delivery. Oh, it's bringing all. It's setting you free. It's setting us free, isn't it? Oh, it's helping us. Oh, let him set you free. Let him set you free because he is in it. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. It's so wonderful. Oh, what a gift. What a gift from above. Oh, it came. It came today. Oh.
Well, that's worth all your practicing. Beautiful. Thank you, Jesus.
I'm trying to sit still, Brother Hill, but I tell you, I'm a blessed person. I'm so blessed. I have a pastor that loves me. Oh, I tell you, 3 years ago in Cincinnati, God revealed to me the man of God that would be in my life. And I'm so thankful that it was there that Jesus moved and showed us where we was going to be. And as far as I'm concerned, for the rest of my life, there's no other place to be. I'm so thankful for the men of God. And we were praying here yesterday morning that God come down on me. And I prayed for each one of them. I was like my pastor. Each one of them were my pastors. I prayed for them. I was so thankful that there's men of God that will tell us the truth, that will stand for truth in a day when it's not popular. I'm so thankful that my ears get to hear the word of God. Hallelujah.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Oh, thank you. Praise you, Jesus, for this. These testimonies and these exhortations of joy. Hallelujah. Victory. Praise God. Thank you very much. I wish we could have them sing all the numbers. But the time is going so fast. We're in our third hour here. It just seems like we're just getting started. The Lord has revealed to me that a precious person is to sing. It's 39 on my list. Heather Brandt from St. Louis, Missouri. Thanks. And this precious one will be singing number 5 on the list. She has 6 numbers. And let us stand now as she's getting ready. And we're going now to trust the Lord for his direction. Brother John, would you lead us in a stanza?
I'm so happy, and here's the reason why. He took my burden away. Glory! Praise the Lord.
I'm so happy, and here's the reason why. He took my burden away. Now I'm singing as I top the faithful Father. He took my burden away.
Yes.
Once my heart was heavy with the load of sin, Jesus took my load and gave me wonderful peace within. And now my time is singing as I took my burden on the way.
Amen. Praise the Lord. That was just too short, wasn't it? You may be seated. No, we're going to stand. I'm sorry. We're not through here yet. Praise the Lord. Guy William?
For it's real, it's real. Oh.
See, I was going to have you be seated, and the Holy Spirit said, wait just a moment. I didn't know what to do next. So then we found out. Praise the Lord.
Glory.
And that's a song of encouragement, a song of assurance and victory and fulfillment. And we give him the praise for it. You may be seated. Praise the Lord for Heather, and may the Lord anoint her and help her, bless her, give her courage and blessing. Praise the Lord, sister. It's number 5, if you please.
Sir.
Thank you. Thank you. So glad to see you. I'll shake hands with you, sister. I'll shake hands with you before you leave. See, I wouldn't have known you, but I was praying while the precious ones were singing. I said, who do you want? And I said, which page? On page one, page two, page three. He operated my heart from page three out of the gate when I came to your name. He said, and if you were to give us it. Oh, that was so sweet. That was so beautiful. Oh, it was so dear.
Oh, God, I praise you, Jesus.
Oh, thank you, Jesus.
Oh,
I thought how miraculous it is that he would tell me you were to sing out of 1,000, 1,100, 1,200 people. And you see, we've never been privileged to shake hands and talk. Praise the Lord. And your song was, and he revealed to me his number five.
It's my favorite one.
It is? Oh, I didn't know it. But it was so beautiful. Oh, it helped me too. It helped all of us. It's a sweet, sweet spirit. Praise the Lord. Thank you for praying for us and singing for Jesus. Thank you. Be careful of that step. So marveled me while you were singing. I said, what's next, Jesus? On the third page, when I came to her with the Holy Spirit. And you see, that's a lot to praise God for. And guiding me to this precious young Christian woman that I've never met, never talked a minute to. And he would tell me it was number five on her list. And it was a keeper of the door. And how Jesus came to wash the feet of clay.
Amen.
Yes, to wash us from our sins.
Right.
And get us ready to be a keeper. Yes. There's a lot we have to go through with to ever be a keeper. They kept it. They kept, he said, and they on good ground kept it in an honest and a pure heart and brought forth 30, 60, and 100-fold.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Isn't it rich?
Praise the Lord.
Praise you, Jesus. There's so many sheets here, I can't find everyone. But, so many people, precious ones. And we're just so indebted to him for his direction, guidance, and blessing. It's been on my heart that Patty and Cindy sing. So would you come and sing, if you please? As those of you that weren't here, we found Patty on a cruise ship because we wanted to surprise Reverend Wright. Praise the servant of God on my left. And because God led me there, we found her. And God has done a great miracle in her and her husband's life and children.
Yes.
It's a great miracle. See, we wouldn't have Cindy if it weren't for that leading and Patty. So we praise God. And I'll sing the one that's on your heart. The one that you get blessed on. She was a religious singer on that cruise ship. And we didn't know her, but more than knew all the other hundreds on there, except just a few people. And so we want to thank Jesus.
I'd like just to mention that we have a
is the architect for our new building in Florida.
Yes, yes.
So I just thought that would be interesting to some people.
And let us share that he said the other night, didn't he, that his life has been helped so much?
Yes, sir. We have been praying all along, Reverend Helm, that in the process of building this facility, which the Lord has witnessed to, that in the process of construction itself, that hearts would be helped, souls would be saved, and saints would be encouraged and lives would be changed. And Glenn said the other night as he was praying up there in our new facility, he said, Lord, little did I know that I would be one of the lives changed in this construction process. And it's been a tremendous blessing of God for Glenn and Patty and their family. And now they have felt led of the Lord that they are now worshiping with us regularly at Palm Beach Gardens Christ Fellowship, and we are humbled by their presence.
Yes.
And what the Lord is doing.
Yes, praise you, Jesus. Yes, you can see that he's been encouraged. Glenn, your husband.
Wow, so much, so much.
Very much.
So much, and I say this to the glory of God.
Thank you, Jesus.
And it's not far, but we drive an hour, God helps us sometimes to, it's like in just an hour, but sometimes it's like an hour and 15 minutes.
Yes.
And It just seems so quick, and it's so wonderful to get ready to worship. And then we're home, and we still haven't finished reviewing and being excited. And if I can just share this one thing.
Please.
We were on our way home one night, and it was very late on a Sunday night, and there was school the next day, and we have a station wagon, so we bring pillows and blankets, and the boys were supposed to go to sleep on the way home. And Glenn and I were talking and thinking the boys were asleep, and we were just thanking the Lord so much for being there, and said, you know, gosh, I mean, what word would say? I mean, how can we say what it is that we are? I mean, it's what? And suddenly out of the back seat, laying down, my oldest son Nathan said, privileged. And we thought he was asleep. He said, privileged. He said, Mommy, I'm not going to sleep. Can I just listen? God is doing such a work. And he's going to the youth
wonderful
camp.
Wonderful.
So great. Oh, can I say one more thing?
Oh, yeah, sure.
We had been at, my husband had been at the church we left for 30 years. And our mother and father, both of our mothers and fathers live in Hollywood.
It's a big church of 2,000, it's about 2,000.
Yes, sir. And, it's been 7 years and since
we found you on that ship.
Put me on that ship. And I just want to encourage people that, you know, maybe you're like I was sitting here and, you know, I was at a couple weddings and, oh, I went to Israel twice.
Yes.
And I thought, oh, if only we could, you know, go to Palm Beach Gardens, but it just didn't seem like it was anything that could ever possibly happen. And how God has worked. And so if you're, you know, maybe you just get to come here once a year or something, but just hold steady.
Yes.
And hold on.
Yes, be faithful.
Oh, what God will do.
Follow Jesus.
So wonderful.
Deny yourself and follow.
So wonderful.
It is. It's a wonderful story of what God has done in your family.
Yes. And the story's not finished being written.
No, it's going on and on. Praise the Lord for the victory.
Praise the Lord.
Victory through the blood. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
We're grateful.
Would it be number one?
That would be fine. You have how many numbers?
We have 4.
Yes. I believe it would be fine for you to say number one. Yes, please. May the Lord anoint you.
First disobeyed the Father, we were then held captive by our sin. The law of God demanded a sacrifice, restoring to himself his own again. So the Lamb, his only Son, was freely offered. Atonement for our sin forever made. He, innocent and holy, still God and God only, could ransom and redeem us back again. Hallelujah, praise the Lamb.
Amen.
Hallelujah, praise the Lamb. My heart sings his praise again. Hallelujah, praise the Lamb. to the cross they carried him, with all our guilt and all our sin. The Lamb of God was slain for our transgressions. And on that cross those nail-pierced hands reached up to God and down to man. Then just as if I'd never sinned, he took me in his arms, embracing me, he willingly forgave. Our mercy, grace, and love that knows no bounds. Though guilty and condemned, I now am free. Forever I'm forgiven, for Christ the Lord is risen, and risen with him we will one day be. Oh, hallelujah, praise the Lamb.
Amen. Thank you so much. I'll shake hands with you both. Praise the Lord. So glad, Cindy, that you could be with us. Praise the Lord. Have you been encouraged? All because of the guidance of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And it's a miracle how God helped us to find this daughter and her husband, a distinguished man, an architect. And he's being used here. And he said something the other day. What a great thing it is to be free. Is that what he said? Oh, he's so happy that he was free. See, he was, I think he was one of the main men of the church. One of the trustees or deacons, Sunday school teacher, visitation. And here the Lord has worked a work of love and light and glory and victory. And even their children are said it was a privilege to be there. And see, that's Hollywood all the way up to Palm Beach Gardens. Hour and 15 minutes, a hard drive. And praise the Lord for his guidance and direction. Now the next one, let's just sing. You help me on this pronunciation.
That's Tammy Kovacs. That's the young lady who was with the help yesterday.
Oh, really? Yes. Oh, is that right?
Amy's friend.
Oh, well, when I got to this page, he said, wait just a moment. I didn't know who. You see, I've got so many. There's just so much. And the Holy Ghost told me she was to sing Love in Any Language. And, of course, I didn't know who she was. I knew she said here, Cleveland, Ohio. And she's going to come. My dear brother, thank you for standing. There's about one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. There's 800 people that like to talk. And so we're going to let him speak anyhow. He already stood. So the rest of you know from now on. Because, see, we'd love for you. We'd love for all of you to talk. It would take days and days, wouldn't it? You know, because we have so much to share. And this is a precious young convert.
Changed my life drastically. I am here from New Jersey via Florida. And Florida there in Palm Beach Gardens has changed my life. It's only 4 months and 7 days since
I've been
saved. And I am so proud. Glory. I am so happy to be
Hallelujah.
A part of this ministry. For us building this new facility has given me a new lease on life. It has changed my life so drastically that just being able to be there and to be and to share with you people,
Hallelujah.
To be in here on this first and my not my last, but my very first worship on God. I have praised God for changing my life, for changing my soul. He has changed me so drastically, getting me out of that darkness. I praise God
Hallelujah.
For my Savior.
Glory
He's my
God.
Salvation.
Jesus.
Oh, Jesus, I love Jesus.
Praise,
oh,
the Lord.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. Praise God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Oh,
Thank
He has
you,
changed
Jesus.
My
Thank
life
you,
so drastically. Thank you, Pastor Mullins. You have changed me. And Reverend Helm, oh,
We're
and Terrence and Martha for letting me share in their house. Oh, Reverend Helm, oh, what it has done for me. Oh, what it has done for me. It has changed me. God bless.
Thank
God
you,
bless.
Jesus,
oh,
for this great
you.
Transformation. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory to God, the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We were with him in a restaurant just a few days ago. I had quite a time. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. This precious daughter. Yes.
Je t'aime. Te amo, ya tibia le blue. Honey, oh heaven, I've come. I love you. The sounds are all as different as the lands from which they came. And though our words are all unique, our hearts are still the same. Love in any language, straight from the heart, pulls us all together, never apart. And once we learn to speak it, all the world will hear. Love in any language, fluently spoken here. We teach the young our differences, yet look how we're the same. We love to laugh, we dream our dreams, we know the sting of pain. From Leningrad to Lexington, the farmer loves his land. And daddies all get misty-eyed to give their daughter's hand. Oh, but when we realize how much there is to share, we find too much in common to pretend it isn't there. Love in any language, straight from the heart, pulls us all together, never apart. And once we learn to speak it, all the world will hear. Worlds apart, there's no misinterpreting the language of the heart.
Thank you. Thank you. Praise the Lord. Amen. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, it's so good. Express your heart. Praise the Lord. Love you. Praise the Lord. She said the Lord has blessed her and operates in her heart. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you. Just think, we didn't know one another and he told me about you.
Thank you, Jesus.
And the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Thank
glory,
you,
glory, glory, glory. Praise the Lord. Thank you. Keep praying for us. This is a marvel. He would tell me because his precious daughter had this song and I didn't know her. And we want to thank Jesus for it. Linda Moore, you're going to sing number 5 on your list. And it's a marvel how God helped us to find you in Asbury through Dr. Kenneth Shaver. And she was about to marry, and the announcements were just about to go out. And Kenneth said to her, are you sure Jesus is leading in this marriage? And she called her mother and said, don't send those out. I want to pray till God leads. And then he revealed to me, because I didn't see her, I didn't know anything about her. He revealed to me that she was to go to the Hubbard family in Michigan. And she stayed there a number of weeks, and she's very quiet, very timid, extremely quiet and timid. But oh, what she can share is a wonder. But God has gotten into this precious daughter. A burden for the church. She has a burden for the lost and a burden for the church. Dr. Roundtree, I tell you, and Blanche, they were so encouraged because she had the burden of the church. And that touches my heart right now. See, it's the burdens in the church. To deny self and to obey. See, that's where our situation is. We get people saved with a million, but they don't know how to deny self. They don't know that denial of self is the first breath after conversion. And they just think it's to have blessings and have great times. It's inner denial just as soon as we're converted. That instant begins. And that is start praising the Lord and give him all the glory for salvation, for redemption.
Amen.
And she has carried the burden of the church for all these years. And she went up to a strange home, backward, shy person. Instead of going home to her parents, they wanted her to come just like all of us. But she went up there and denied herself. She denied herself and obeyed and went up there for days and weeks and then came to the waiting upon God. I didn't know who she was. Only he had told me about her. And here God revealed to me that she was to sing. And she's going to sing that song. Something wonderful is about to happen. And it did. And oh, what a day. And you know, after you had married, after God had revealed that James and you were to be husband and wife, and the Holy Ghost blessed so sweetly, and James would tell his mother and father, oh, how precious it was. After you had lived together 6 years, how many years have you been together now?
It'll be 16 in August.
16? After 6 years that you had been with your sweetheart and your husband, You told his mother one day, to Jesus' glory, because of God, in Christ, the blood of Christ. You said, if my husband has any faults, I don't know what they are. Now that is so great. And he said to his mother and father, he said, if of all the women, you were the one for him. You could help him and love him and bear the burden. And you see, this is a great gift of God. That the Holy Ghost knew about it. Jesus knew about it. Oh, what? I remember you were on your anniversary with us in Oklahoma. And your husband was so happy. He just prayed, you know, a couple and a half hours ago. And oh, what a time we had. Praise the Lord. How Jesus is blessed. And he took you, you know, when we were back home. You had such a great time from the waiting upon God. And he took you to an older people. He went out and he was speechless. He didn't know what to do with this burden. And you knew what to do. And the Holy Ghost just spoke to you the very things that these old people needed. And he knew God was leading. Praise the Lord. This is number 5. Praise the Lord. Pray for her. Anoint her. Bless her. Help her. Lift her. Heal her. What a miracle God has just done here.
Amen.
See, her parents, when they came to Asbury for a commencement, they wanted to go back to Sacramento, but God said for her to go to a place she'd never been. And that family's very outgoing, and here she's backward. She denied herself, came down here, and God gave her a prince.
Amen.
And he received a queen in Jesus our Savior for the Holy Ghost. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. See, it's a miracle. It's a miracle of God's power and sweetness of His grace. Hallelujah. We want to thank Him and praise Him and adore Him and glorify Him for what He's doing, what He does, and what He is working now in our hearts together. Praise God.
Praise God.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Thank you very much. That the Holy Ghost would reveal you are the one to sing. And you were to sing number 5, and I didn't know what it was. And that's what we're here for. You're singing what we're here. We've been doing it now for hours and hours, a day, waiting upon the Lord. See, in these songs, He's teaching us. He's teaching us. In the message, in the scripture, He's teaching us. In prayer, He's teaching us. He's teaching us as we trust for the next guidance and direction. Praise the Lord. Thank you very much, Linda. My, it was like old camp meeting days. See, George Newell was born he was born when the glory was falling. His mother was an old-fashioned saint. I tell you, she'd shout in the night. Sally said, "What's going on?" He said, "Oh, mother's praying, getting happy."
Amen.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, it's a wonderful story of love. And I see we've been here now, going in the 4th hour. And you know, an old man like me, and he's in a meeting for 2 or 3 hours, should he be a little weary?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Just think of it. I have young men that in 3-hour service, they have to go home and lie down the rest of the day and part of the next day to recover. Just 1 3-hour service. If you have the responsibility, and you can't imagine unless you experience it. And these men know a little bit of what I'm talking about. And we're thankful to Jesus for the Holy Ghost to guide and to direct. I know we're supposed to eat in 30 minutes, and I wanted to hear Joy Bell and the sons, and I wanted to hear the McAdams family sing, you know. But here we are. Having a time. Joy Bell, bring the sons and sing a song for Jesus. And it's you that haven't heard it. God led me in 1955, and because of that leading on a highway in Tennessee, we have this family, Reverend Cox and his family, the Merediths. Because of that guidance. I don't know where all that list is, so you can send it up here to me, because it's in this book, but it takes a long while to go through here. You just can't imagine. You can imagine, but to try to find and all the various... Thank you. Thank you very much. Number 5. Bach, number 15. 7:15. Thank you. Very sweet.
fell, uns in da fell oft. Ui, forget the blue schnitz, as dore the macht. Mir hat sich verdämmen, mir Freude gebracht. So künftig, tot Teufel, uns in da fell oft.
Beautiful. Hallelujah. That was in German, wasn't it? That was in German? That was in German. Praise the Lord. Did you enjoy it? We did. Oh, I wish we could hear you for 30, 40, 50 minutes anyhow.
Amen.
Yes. Because it's rare in the world. Rare in churchdom.
That's
right. Yeah, praise us. Yes, we appreciate it immensely. Thank you. I believe we, even though the time is gone, they may have to wait on us in there this time. This is Twinkle, number 9. Well, I hate to see him leave. He's so sweet. Yes, praise the Lord. Get that oboe ready, or the bassoon rather. But read.
Brantley had an incurable disease, and we would have lost him had the Lord not healed and helped.
Oh, Jesus, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
He was ill for several years before the doctors could even begin to diagnose the problem. And it was a fluke that they ever did diagnose it. We just went to a doctor who was one of those real thorough sort of people, and he just decided to run some tests just because he had blood and he could do it. And he had a just almost no immune system. It just wasn't there. And so this song has special meaning for me because Brantley used to sing this when he was sick.
Oh.
Shining wonder that you are, wonder how you ever came to be. Twinkle, twiddle, go little star, maybe there's a miracle for me.
Oh, and you got it. You received it.
I've heard many others say, joy is just a wish away.
Jesus.
Your mind, your dreams. that you are. Wonder how you ever came to be. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, Jesus, is that miracle for me? Jesus, is that miracle for me?
Beautiful. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Oh, that was so precious. We want to praise Jesus for that. Wouldn't it be wonderful if we had another hour or two?
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Because listen, this is the gift of God. Praise the Lord. Now, we have Michael Benjamin, because God led me in 1951, 41 years ago, or we wouldn't have him. And he's going to play with Beverly now. Ye servants of God, ye servants of God. If you're denying self and you're obeying the Holy Spirit and the leading of the Lord, then you're a servant of God. But if we're not denying self and doing only what Jesus leads, we're just playing religion. Is that right?
Yes, sir.
Is that true?
I believe it.
Because inner denial is the first step. You're a servant of God when you deny yourself and do exactly what he says. Mm. Not what we plan, not what we want, but what he leads. Because for as many as are led by the Spirit, they are the sons of God. So that verse said that we're to be led of the Holy Ghost. And we can't do it. It's as we deny self and wait upon him, then he refines us and gets out of us what's keeping us from being led. Now that's sermon enough. For a long time. Really? That ought to make us so shouting happy to learn a secret of the universe, the secret of time, and the secret of humanity to find the place where they have sought to be and to go. Praise the Lord. Your servants of God. Just think, we have him because God led in 1951 before he was born. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. It's the servants of God. Praise the Lord. Thank you so very much. We'd like to hear about 30, 40, 50, 60, 70 minutes of that. And last night, or yesterday sometime, when he gave all the variations, and they weren't on that page. I mean, he'd give the variations once, and it was different the second time, different the third time, through Jesus helping him. Beverly, thank you for playing the piano. Thank you, Michael. All right, the McAdams children, would you come, please? I don't know where your seat is. It's amidst here somewhere, but I don't know where. It takes me a while. We're supposed to be at the lunch hour in 15 minutes. We just haven't. We're trusting. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. You pray for me to have strength. Because, see, we've had a camp meeting here. Oh, someone has something in the head. In the name of Jesus of Nazareth, be thou whole and be thou lifted now and made well for Jesus' glory. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, Jesus healeth thee. Amen. This is in the head. Praise the Lord. Now, cancer, die in the name of Jesus. I ask this cancer to die in the name of Jesus. I ask it to die for Jesus' glory. Behold in Jesus' name. Here comes John, so he'll be here in a few seconds. Praise the Lord. Thank you so very much. Number four.
O.C. Freeman.
Yes. See, when I come to the number, it operates in my heart. And so I need some water. It's about worshiping the Lord and putting God first.
Vyum bevyo devya mungu etu nam fame etu vyum bevyo devya mungu etu nam fame etu upase ni sauti ili nasim Pazeni sauti ili nasim uimbe. Watu wote viumbe vyote awaye ote sifu Mungu. Watu wote viumbe vyote awaye ote sifu Mungu.
All creatures of our God and King,
osifuni Mungu.
Lift up your voice and with us sing,
osifuni Mungu.
That burning sun with golden beam,
imbani, imbani.
Thou silver moon with softer gleam,
bazeni sauti, imbani. Viumbe vyote vya Mungu wetu na mfalme wetu. Viumbe vyote vya Mungu wetu na mfalme wetu. Pazeni sauti, ili nasi mwimbe. Pazeni sauti, ili nasi mwimbe. Amen. All creatures, everybody, praise the Lord. Amen. All creatures, everybody, praise the Lord.
Thou rushing wind that art so strong,
osifuni Mungu.
Ye clouds that sail in heaven along,
osifuni Mungu.
Thou rising morning prayers rejoice,
imbani, imbani.
Ye lights of evening find a voice,
pazeni sauti, imbani. Viumbe vyote vya Mungu wetu na mfalme wetu. Viumbe vyote vya Mungu wetu na mfalme wetu. Pazeni sauti, ili nasi mwimbe. Pazeni sauti, ili nasi mwimbe. Amen.
Watu wote,
all creatures, everybody,
awaye yote,
praise the Lord. Amen.
Watu wote,
all creatures, everybody,
awaye yote,
praise the Lord. Thou flowing water pure and clear, make music for thy Lord to hear. Thou fire so masterful and bright, impeni, that givest man both warmth and light. Viumbe vyote vya Mungu wetu, viumbe vyote vya Mungu wetu. Pazeni sauti. Pazeni sauti. To see the Mungu.
Let all things their creator bless.
O Sikuni Mungu.
And worship him in humbleness.
O Sikuni Mungu.
Oh, praise the Father, praise the Son.
In Beni,
hallelujah.
In Beni.
And praise the Spirit three in one.
Pazeni sauti in Beni. View me built there, ya Mungu etu, not fame wetu. View me built there, ya Mungu etu, not fame wetu. Pazeni sauti. Ili nasim wimbe. Pazeni sauti. Ili nasim wimbe. Amen.
What to what day?
All creatures.
Your day.
Everybody. Praise the Lord. Amen.
What to what day?
All creatures.
Your day.
Everybody. Praise the Lord. Oh, Sifuni Mungu. Oh, Sifuni Mungu. Oh, Sifuni Mungu.
To
Sifu
Mungu.
Oh, Sifuni Mungu. Oh, Sifuni Mungu. Oh, Sifuni Mungu.
To
Sifu
Mungu.
To
Sifu
Mungu. To Sifu Mungu. To Sifu Mungu. Hazeni sauti na wote mbeni. Oh, Sifuni Mungu.
Praise the Lord. That got in my heart. Ushers, come forth. Ushers, come forth real quick. Let the ushers come forth real quick, real quick, and take an offering while they're singing, Behold the Savior. Get all the men down here and take up the offering. We sanctify and bless it. We bless it in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Thank you, Jesus, for working in our hearts, for reviving us and lifting us and giving us the victory and giving us joy unspeakable. We want to praise you, Lord, for the work of thy love in our hearts. And all these that have the fire in their soul, we pray for every soul to be encouraged, and for the disconsolate, for the discouraged, the weary, the worn, and for those, oh Lord, that need help, everyone. In Jesus' name, let the offering be sanctified.
Behold the Savior of mankind, nailed to the shameful tree.
Magnificent. Oh, Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. What a message. Oh, what a message about Jesus. Praise the Lord. Oh, that's so great, John. Praise the Lord. So good to have you and your sisters here. See, these are the children of our secretary, Reverend and Mrs. McAdams. Dad, would you stand, please, so they can see the mother of these children? She has a woman of prayer. She prays and the victory comes. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. She prays. I'll tell you, when God anoints you, right.